Good morning and welcome to Hope for the Family with Evangelist Prayer Engineer Eden. God is good all the time. We bless God for keeping us alive to see this beautiful day which He has made. We rejoice and be glad in it. Shouts of victory and rejoicing are heard all the time in the tent of the righteous. We bless God that we are His children. We thank God for the love He has lavished on us. Amen. That we are called the children of God and we are the children of God. Amen. We bless God for His faithfulness because of the love of God for us. The world does not know us because God has not accepted that Jesus Christ is the Son of the living God. The world has refused to accept the truth that God has passed on to us. But we bless God for giving us each a measure of faith that we are holding on to the truth that God is our God. In the name of Jesus, that Jesus Christ is our Lord. And that's why we are rejoicing today, because our names are written in heaven. We have every reason to thank our God. We have every reason to show for the praise of our God to the world that has refused to accept the testimony of God, that Jesus Christ is our Lord, that there is no other way through which men may be reconciled back to God the Father, but it's through Jesus Christ. So this morning, we want to make reference to 1 John chapter 1. Glory, hallelujah, amen. We want to remind ourselves of the kind of love that God has lavished on us. When you lavish something on somebody, you give a surplus of all the person needs. Amen. So the love of God to us, the love that God has given to us, is surplus, overflowing. That love is to overflow from us to everyone around us today. As God has loved us, we have to love everyone. We are to love everyone around us today in the mighty name of Jesus. It's the will of God for us to be shadows of His love and peace to the world we live in the name of Jesus. To remind men of what God has done for us, what God has given to us, of who we are in the hands of God. That we are mighty in the hands of our God to put down strokes of the wicked. Glory, hallelujah, amen. As we meditate on this word today, we pray that the Spirit of God will quicken us to know what we have in us, what God has given to us, and what God wants to do in us and through us. That from our mouths we begin to proclaim the goodness of God. We begin to testify about the faithfulness of God to the world around us, beginning from our families. That we bring our children to know God in the name of Jesus. That we bless God for everything He has done for us and our families and nations, because we know that God truly loves us. That the love of God for us is unfailing. That is our God. We bless Him for the overflowing blessings that He has given to us. Fresh anointing this morning. That He has provided all our needs. We lack nothing good because of His love for us. Because of His love for us, He sent His Son to die for us. Because of His love for us, He made us to be His ambassadors in this world, the ones that will take forth the message of salvation to the nations. He is the glory and the lifter of our heads. We lack nothing good. He has given us the ability, the power to do all things through our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, who gives us strength. He has given us His Holy Spirit today. We have come into the most holy place through the blood of Jesus Christ, that blood that has cleansed us from all unrighteousness. This morning, as we meditate on the word of God, we ask for forgiveness in ways that we have fallen short of the glory of God. We plead the blood of Jesus Christ on ourselves and our families and nations. We ask for forgiveness. For God has shown us mercy. God has not condemned us of any wrong to Him. We must show mercy to our brothers and sisters, everyone that have offended us today. We release them in the name of Jesus. Because judgment without mercy will be shown to anyone that cannot forgive their brothers and sisters that have sinned against them. We lay down bitterness, malice, unforgiving spirit, the spirit of Cain, every slanderous spirit of envy, jealousy, at the feet of Jesus Christ today, where we receive deliverance from every evil force of darkness. Father, we bless You. We bless You for who You are to us. We thank You for Your great love, Your unfailing love towards us. We bless You for feeding us every day with a living word, the word of God that is active in our lives, that produces the fruit of righteousness, that produces the fruit of righteousness in us. We bless You, God, that our repentance will produce the fruit of righteousness today. We thank You, God, that we can come before You this morning to enjoy fellowship with You, with the Son, and with the Spirit. We bless You, God, that we are going out in Your name today. that we are blessed wherever we go today. We uproot and dismantle every struggle, every imagination, insinuation of darkness, every thought that will lift up a standard against your knowledge in our lives today. We are pulling them down by your mighty power today in the name of Jesus. As you stretch our hands to fight, in the mighty and precious name of Jesus, we bless you for your right hand, Father Lord. We bless you for that, Lord, because you are pulling down everything standing in our path today in the name of Jesus. You are helping us today. We bless you, our Father. We thank you that wisdom is speaking to us today in the name of Jesus. Our ears are attentive to the voice of wisdom today. We are drawing closer to you. As we draw closer to you, you draw closer to us in the name of Jesus. We thank you, God. You are God. From our bellies are overflowing springs of living waters today. We thank you, God. We thank you that you have lifted up our heads above every opposition, every spirit of hindering spirit in our families, Lord God. Every spirit of witchcraft in the mighty name of Jesus. Every spirit of evil. Yet the enemies are gathered for that, Lord. You cannot be found there. They are gathered in vain. You have pulled in them. You have scattered them. You have confused them, Jehovah God. That they are falling into the pit. They are dark for us. Oh, Father, thank you for breaking every snare today. Thank you for uprooting every strike erected in our families. Every curse spoken against us and our families have been overturned by your mighty power. We thank you for great deliverance for us and our families today. We bless you, God, for filling our quivers with children, for blessing us with our children. Glory, hallelujah, amen. For our children are inheritance from you. We bless you, God, because blessing of the womb is a reward from you. We bless you that our children will prosper in good works. You have separated them from everything evil. You have given them the spirit of knowledge, understanding, intelligence. You have enlightened their eyes, Lord God, that they can see spiritual things in the name of Jesus, that they can walk on the path you have laid for them. We bless you, God, that they prosper in every good works in the name of Jesus. Thank you for blessing them with spiritual blessings, Lord God, in high places. Christ Jesus. Thank you for elevating them, Jehovah God, that they advance to the position of authority in our nations, Lord God. We bless you, God, that they are kings and queens, princesses and princes in the name of Jesus, that they are heads of states, they are governors in the name of Jesus, they are mayors of towns and cities, they are congressmen and women, senators, Father Lord, we bless you. Councilmen and women, we bless you in the name of Jesus, that in every profession on earth, that they are found there in Jesus' mighty name. Oh, Father Lord, we bless you, that they are able to acquire the education and skills they need to become responsible citizens. We bless you, God, that you are shaking the foundation of evil in our communities and you are overturning upon the heads of the wicked ones gathered against us and our nations, Father Lord. You are pulling back, Father Lord, their hands, Lord God. Oh, Father Lord, we behave the same that I have. Their evil returning upon them in the name of Jesus. You are cleansing our schools and every institution, Father Lord, every behaviors of government of evil in the name of Jesus. Those taking pornography, those using our children in sex trade and child labor, those introducing them to alcoholism and drug addiction in the name of Jesus, you are lifting up a standard against them. Those enticing the children and making them to run away from their families, oh Father, you are lifting up a standard against them. You are uprooting from our midst every form of depravity of souls in the name of Jesus, Father Lord. You have arisen to us this morning. You are our God, oh Father. You have lavished us with your love. We thank you for what you are doing in our midst, Lord God. Yes, Lord, we bless you, God, in Jesus' mighty name. Thank you for putting in position your children in our schools, in our government, in the name of Jesus, in our hospitals, Father Lord. We bless you for positioning your children to do great works for you. In the name of Jesus, for overturning, Father Lord, every plan of the wicked, for giving your children inner strength to prevail against the forces of darkness. Oh God, we bless you, for anointing them afresh this day, for holding their hands, Lord God, as they walk for you in the name of Jesus, so that we bless you, God, that evil cannot prevail in our midst because you are our God in the name of Jesus. Oh Father, we thank you for sending forth your word today to heal us of our sicknesses and diseases. We thank you, Lord God, for rebuking the spirit of infirmities on our behalf today. We bless you for rebuking the spirit of cancer, Father Lord, the spirit of ulcer in the name of Jesus, of ulcers in the name of Jesus. Every attack on our memories, you are rebuking on our behalf today. We bless you, God, for touching our reproductive organs today, that your children are able to carry pregnancy, oh Lord God, to full term in the name of Jesus. We bless you for rebuking miscarriages, oh Lord God, and every attack, oh Lord God, on our pregnant doctors, Father Lord. In you are protecting them and the children in the wombs in the name of Jesus. Thank you for miracles house, O Lord God. Oh, there's no barrenness in your house, O Lord God. That your children looking up to you for the blessing of the womb, Father Lord. You are touching them in the name of Jesus. They are bringing forth their children into this world in the name of Jesus. We bless you, God. That your spirit is overing around in maternity and helping your children to bring forth their children into this world. Jehovah God, you have rebuked death and childbirth in the name of Jesus. You have overturned the curse in the mighty name of Jesus. You have shaken the foundation of evil on behalf of your children today. Oh, Father Lord, every complication and childbirth, Father Lord, have been overturned by your mighty power. Father Lord, cords around the necks of children have been loosened by your mighty power. Oh, children that are not in the right position, Jehovah God, you are overturning and breaking everything to be perfect according to your will. We come against the spirit of witchcraft and evil. We come against you attacking the families. We come against you that are gathered in vain. We come against you that sit down in the night time instead of sleeping and planning evil on your bed. We come against you the hands of God and lifted up against you. For God is the glory and the lift up of our heads. Our God is our helper. In the name of Jesus, everything concerning us and our families and nations will be according to the will of God on earth as it is in heaven. Our God prevails in our matters in the name of Jesus. Oh, Father, we thank you. We are hearing shouts of victory and rejoicing. We are hearing great testimonies of the things you are doing in our midst. We are hearing, Father Lord, that your children are standing up from their sick beds, Lord God. They are lifting up their hands to glorify you today. We are thanking you, Father Lord, as you are touching the hands of the doctors and all the medical personnel taking care of your children in their various specialties, Jehovah God. As you are releasing wisdom upon them, as you are using them to do great works for you. We are thanking for the great testimony of breakthrough in medical science. We are blessing for the professors in the colleges that you are using, Father Lord, and universities to do great works in the name of Jesus. We are thanking you, God, because the earth must be filled of the knowledge of your goodness and your faithfulness to us, of your love that which you have lavished upon us in the name of Jesus, so that we bless you this morning. We thank you that you are frustrating the kingdom of darkness on our behalf today, that you are frustrating those gathered against us in the medical profession, gathered against us in the pharmaceutical companies, oh Father Lord, in the laboratories, every technician working for the force of darkness, Father Lord, you are shaking them this morning in the name of Jesus. We thank you for what you alone can do. We bless you, God, Rebbe Heber Center, for those that manufacture good medicine. We thank you for your children working for you. We bless you, God, that you are prospering them in good works. We bless you that you are blessing them and their families in the name of Jesus. Oh, Father, we thank you. You are our God. There's no God at stake. We bless you, God, because you are involved in the affairs of men. We thank you, Jehovah God, Rebbe Heber Center. The wicked forces of darkness cannot find an entrance to our homes. We are trampling upon them this morning. We are frustrating them this morning because you have given us the power to do so. You have given us the power to shake principality and to bring down under the feet of Jesus Christ. Oh, Father, we are mighty in your hands to do great works. Oh, God, we are blessing you. You are rebuking death by sudden stroke and heart attack. You are touching our arteries and the veins, Lord God, of our hearts, Lord God. You are touching our nerves today. You are touching every part of our bodies today. In the name of Jesus, you prevail in matters concerning us because you have a great love for us in the name of Jesus. It was that love that made you to send your Son, our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ, to die for us while we are sinners in the name of Jesus. Father, you have not heard anything back from us in the name of Jesus. We triumph in good works, Lord God. We are whole in our health, Lord God. We are total awareness in the name of Jesus. In our minds and our emotional health in the name of Jesus. You are rebuking everything according to your will on our behalf today. You are rebuking the kingdom of death on our behalf today. You are snatching your children, Father Lord, from the kingdom of darkness and bringing them into your marvelous light. In the name of Jesus. Oh, Father, thank you for what you alone can do in our lives, Lord God. Thank you, Lord God, for touching every organ in our bodies today. Oh, Father, we bless you for pressing out of our body everything that should not be there in the name of Jesus. For flushing out of our blood every attack of the enemy today. For touching all our body cells today. In the mighty name of Jesus, every organ will function according to your will. Our liver, Lord God, our lungs, Lord God, our kidneys in the name of Jesus, our heart and arteries, Lord God, in the name of Jesus, every vein in Jesus' mighty name. Oh, Jehovah, we bless you, God, in the name of Jesus. Our memories, Lord God, we remind the things we need to remember. Oh, we reason our rights because you are giving us the ability to make sound judgment. In the name of Jesus, oh, Father, we come against every attack today. You, oh, Rabbi Heber Center, Rabbi Heber Center, you are touching our eyes that we can see clearly. In the name of Jesus, you are rebuking blindness and you are coma in the name of Jesus. Oh, Father, we thank you. We bless you, God. You are touching our lower back today. In the name of Jesus, there's no pain anywhere in our bodies today. You are touching us by your mighty power, Jehovah God. You are returning every evil arrow upon the heads of the senders in the mighty name of Jesus. Oh, you're doing great works in our bodies today. We thank you, God. In the name of Jesus, our hands have been strengthened by you too, Father God. You are giving us a holy stretch all over our body today that only you alone can do. That we are receiving strength, Lord God. Restoration of the things belonging to us, Lord God. Perfect health in the lives of your children in the name of Jesus. Oh, Father, you are touching our lives and small intestine today. Oh, Father, we bless you. You are touching our fingers, our hands, Lord God. You're touching, oh, rather, our hands, Lord God. Our shoulders in the name of Jesus are lifting up every weight today. In the name of Jesus, you are touching, Father, our legs and our toes and every part of our bodies today. You are touching our knees today. In the name of Jesus, you are touching, Father, Lord, our hearing organs and our ears today. Yes, in the name of Jesus, you are touching our throat, our mouth, and our tongue that we speak as your oracles. You are touching our feet today. In the name of Jesus, oh God Almighty, every organ within our thoracic cavities, you are touching today. In the back of our shin and our abdominal cavities, you are touching today. In the name of Jesus, oh Father, you are touching today. Everything that you need to touch about us today, you are shaking the foundation of evil. In the name of Jesus, things that do not belong to our body are falling off today. Things that should die are dying today. Things that should be restored are restored by your mighty power. Because of the love you have lavished on us today. In the name of Jesus, you are our Father. We bless you, God. Oh, Father, you are leading us on the path on which we walk on, that will not fall into temptation. You are God, Father, Lord. You do not tempt any man. Let no man say that I tempted, Father, Lord, when they fall into temptation. We are tempted when you are drawn away from you. Oh, Father, Lord, when he is sent. We allow, Father, Lord, sin, Father, Lord, God, to produce, oh, Lord, God, death in us in the mighty name of Jesus. Oh, Father, Lord, our desires, oh, Lord, God, let them be right in the name of Jesus. Let us seek righteousness, Father, Lord. Let us seek first the kingdom of God and its righteousness, and every other thing will be added unto us. In the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus, we come against, Father, Lord, the craving of the eyes of our God. We come against the lust, Lord God, of flesh. We come against the pride of life. In the name of Jesus, oh, arise unto us today. Let us seek, Father, Lord, righteousness in everything we do. In the name of Jesus, let us be shyness of your peace. Let us show your love to our brothers and sisters, Father, Lord. Let us have considerate hearts to one another. Oh, lead us, Spirit of the living God, today. Let the will of God be done in our families in the name of Jesus. Let the will of God be done in our nations and our government. Oh, within the body of Christ today. Let us gather in your name in the name of Jesus. Let everything out of you be overturned by your mighty power in the name of Jesus. Let us seek you. Let us seek you in everything we do today. Let your Spirit speak to us today. Oh, Father, we thank you in the name of Jesus. As we go into the new year, Jehovah God, we are going in your name in the name of Jesus. You will make everything victorious for us. You are releasing upon us the spirit of good success. You are rebuking every plan of the wicked against us today. You are overturning what they are plotting against us. You are turning knots today. In the name of Jesus, you are breaking chains, oh my God. We are victorious. We are leaping over walls today. In the name of Jesus, walls are coming down on our behalf today. Oh, glory, hallelujah, amen. Father, you will have the praise in every matter concerning us because of the great love you have lavished on us, oh my God. Oh, Father, we are filled with rejoicing this day because we know our God, we are strong for you. We do great works for you. We are entering 2016 with great love of God. There may be heaven sent that confidence in our spirit that we shall see the goodness of God in the land of the living, that you have made the boundary line to fall on us in pleasant places. We are running our races to the end in the name of Jesus. Oh, we are not giving up because Father, your Spirit will help us in the name of Jesus. What you have started in our lives, you will finish in the mighty name of Jesus. We thank you for the spirit of fruitfulness in our families. We are fruitful in the things we do in the name of Jesus. It's by being fruitful that people know that we are your children, Jehovah God. We bless you, God, for the ministry you have given to us, Lord God. We thank you, God, that you have called us to the ministry of reconciliation. We thank you that your sons are husbands, Lord God, and our children, oh Lord God, I may hear the sin that brothers, oh Lord God, are praising their homes in the name of Jesus. That they demonstrate to their children how to love you, how to serve you, Jehovah God. That they are busy in ministry work in the name of Jesus. That they seek you, Father Lord. That they have the fear of you in their hearts, oh Lord God. You bless them and their families, Jehovah God. You rebuke the enemy on their behalf in the name of Jesus. Oh God Almighty, you have made their children only sheets around their tables, oh Lord God. And their wives are proven vines within their homes, oh Lord God. You have united them and their wives in ministry work in the name of Jesus. No weapon fashioned against them, their families will prosper. Anyone that tries to penetrate into their relationship, Father Lord. Let the arrow from above descend upon their tent in the name of Jesus. Let God rebuke them. Let them be shaken, that we come against the spirit of adultery in the name of Jesus. We come against every eye, Father Lord, that will try to cause confusion in our relationship. We lift up and stand against them. We come against every lying tongue in the name of Jesus. Father, arise unto us in the name of Jesus. Our families are stable in the name of Jesus. We prosper in good works in Jesus' mighty name. But if family is the smallest unit of society, if our families are stable, the society is stable. In the name of Jesus, we come against every attack in our families in the mighty name of Jesus. We are holding on to the ordinances you have passed on to us. That the marriage is the relation between a man and a woman, a union between a man and a woman. As you have received, we have passed it on to our children. We rebuke you, the spirit of Satan, we come against you. Every lying spirit trying to come against what God has ordained for us. In the name of Jesus. That's the way we are fruitful. That's the way we can reproduce. So we marry male to female. Oh God Almighty, we present our children to you today. They are good and perfect gifts you have given to us. You have blessed them. You have touched them, Jehovah God. They will marry male to female in the name of Jesus. We rebuke the spirit of lesbianism. We come against the spirit of homosexuality. We come against every form of defilement. Jehovah God, we dip our children in the blood of Jesus Christ. May the new people for you today. Forgive us and our children in ways we have gone contrary to your wish, Jehovah God. We come against everyone that abuse our children for evil purposes. Arise unto our children and help them. In the name of Jesus, return them back, restore them to their former position, higher than they were before, in the name of Jesus, according to your will. Jehovah God, let them hate evil. In the name of Jesus, let them turn their back against anything that is evil. Oh, deliver them from anyone trying to use them for evil purposes. Oh, just recruit them to gangs, oh Lord God, maybe heaven sender. Just learn to bring them to terrorist sex in the name of Jesus. Our children are blessed, oh Lord God. They will not bring sorrow into their families in the name of Jesus. We break every reproach, every plan of the enemy. We overturn every shame in the name of Jesus. Oh, we bless you, God. That our children that are old enough will get married. Oh God, let me him send that about whole shed. We are restoring to them the things that belong to them. No one can take what you have given to them. No one can hold back their destiny. In the name of Jesus, you are shaking the foundation of evil on behalf of our children, Jehovah God. We bless you, our Father. In the name of Jesus, we lift up the banner of Jesus Christ today. We say it is well for us and our families and nations in the name of Jesus. We bless you, God, in the mighty and precious name of Jesus, that our children have their own children. They live down to see their children's children. In the name of Jesus, as we live down to see our children's children, in the name of Jesus. Oh, Father, we bless you. You are our God. You are refreshing this morning. You are leading us beside still waters. You are reviving our souls, oh Lord God. You are setting tables with us in the presence of our enemies. The tables have been set and we are feeding. We are on those tables. You are not afraid of what the wicked will do unto us. Your goodness and mercy will lead us wherever we go today. You have made us strong pillars within your house, oh Lord God. We do great and mighty works for you in the name of Jesus. Your rod and staff will protect us against the devices of the wicked today. We uproot everything that stands in our path today. We trample upon scorpions, snakes, and principalities. We pull down, Father Lord, wickedness within family. We come against familiar spirit, oh Lord God. We come against the spirit of the occult within and outside of our families today. Oh Father, wherever we go today, oh we go, Father Lord, in your name. We thank you for your abiding presence in our situations, oh Lord God. We bless you with your unfailing love. We thank you for the love you have lavished upon us. In the name of Jesus, we are feeding on that love today. In the mighty name of Jesus, we are boasting in you today because you are God. You have helped us in the name of Jesus. Oh Father, we see prosperity around us. We come against the spirit of poverty and lack. In the name of Jesus, there's no lack in our families, there's no poverty. We come against you, curse. We come against you, injury spirit. We come against you, spirit of obstacle. We come against the spirit of witchcraft. We come against you, strength erected in families. We pull you down. We come against the covenant taken on behalf of children. These children that are not even born yet. You that have dedicated generations of children to idols. We come against you by the blood of Jesus Christ. We release our children today. We dedicate them to God. We brought out their names from every occult register in the name of Jesus. Oh Father Lord, wherever spirits are being conjured up against us, those spirits, oh Lord God, are being confused this day. They cannot prosper against us because we are the children of God. Wherever items relating to us, belonging to us, and our children have been taken for evil purposes, we are snatching them from them this day. They belong to us. No man can take what what belongs to us. In the name of Jesus, the aroma of vices, O Lord God, have been traded in spiritual realm, Jehovah God. We come against, O Lord God, that evil spirit, Jehovah God. In the name of Jesus, Jesus Christ is destined on our behalf today. We frustrate the kingdom of darkness today. Father, arise unto us and help us in the name of Jesus. You are our God, deliver us. Deliver our nations, O Lord God, from every evil dedication to the kingdom of darkness. In the name of Jesus, restore back to us and our nations the things that belong to us. We come against the spirit of corruption. In the name of Jesus, we come against every spirit working with the forces of darkness in our nations, O Lord God. As we lift up our government to you today, oh Father, prevail in our government in the name of Jesus. We pray, Father Lord, that the presence of nations, O Lord God, and those in position of authority in our nations, Father Lord, we go back, Father Lord, to begin to review the things they have done in the nations that are contrary to your will, to begin to overturn them all in the name of Jesus. Father, prevail that your children in government will lift up the banner of Jesus Christ, that they will not be ashamed of the gospel of Jesus Christ, that they will stand and speak as your oracles in the name of Jesus. Use them to do great works for you in the nations, O Lord God. Use them to overturn everything not of you in the name of Jesus. Let them trample upon everything contrary to the will of God. Father, prevail in our government today in the name of Jesus. We are lifting up to you this morning our law enforcement. We are lifting up to you today the military in the name of Jesus, the FBI, the Secret Service, O Lord God, the immigration officers in the mighty name of Jesus, those who are on the borders, O Lord God, guiding all about the nations in the name of Jesus. Oh Father, we pray all we do good work for you in Jesus' mighty name. We pray that all we surrender to your will in the name of Jesus. We pray that now we connive, Father Lord, with the forces of darkness, O Lord God, that now we allow, Father Lord, people that we will cause problems in our communities to come in the name of Jesus. Jehovah God, arise unto us, O Lord God. Be the defense, O Lord God, in heaven, sin in our borders in the name of Jesus. We pray, Jehovah God, that you enlighten the eyes of those walking, Father Lord, in the name of Satan, that they will see clearly. Oh, Rabbi, come, Shinda. We come against every spirit of racial profiling in the name of Jesus. We come against every spirit of discrimination. We come against every evil spirit, Jehovah God. We pray that your children will surrender to you as they walk, Jehovah God, that they will fight against the real people, Father Lord, that are threat to your children in the name of Jesus. Don't those, Father Lord, trying to make a living in the mighty and precious name of Jesus. Oh, Father, we overturn any policy, Father Lord, that will make people to suffer in the name of Jesus. Arise unto us and help us, O Lord God. We come against anything that will make families to be separated, O Lord God. Families that are not causing problems, Jehovah God. We pray, Jehovah God, that you help them in the name of Jesus. Oh, Rabbi, have a sender to be here, that the families of Himasher will receive the help they need in the nations they are in the name of Jesus. Arise unto us, our Father, and help us. You are our God. We bless you this morning. Oh, God Almighty, as we lift up the judiciary to you, as we lift up the defender of corruption to you, in the name of Jesus, we pray this day that any judge that will sit down on the bench, Lord God, that does not have the true love of humanity, that will not judge in truth, in justice, Lord God, and in love, Jehovah God, that you, their position will become vacated by your mighty power. Frustrate them, Jehovah God. Let the spirit of unrest descend upon them. Let their sin become new heart for them in the name of Jesus. Father Lord, let your children arise into positions to, Father Lord, in the judiciary in the name of Jesus. Let them become judges of the nations in the name of Jesus. Those that have the true love of God in their hearts, Lord God, for humanity in the name of Jesus. Those that will uphold justice and truth in the name of Jesus. For the throne is established, Lord God, in truth and justice, Father Lord. Anything that will not uphold truth and justice, let it be vacated, Father Lord, in the name of Jesus. Father, arise unto us and help us in the name of Jesus. We bless you, God, as we come, we dedicate to you today, we, your children that are incarcerated, Jehovah God. For we know there are great men and women in the prisons, Father. Arise unto them today. Touch them, Jehovah God. Use them to do great works, O Lord God. Send the prison ministry to them, Father Lord. To minister to them, to bring them to repentance in the name of Jesus. Oh, Father, touch them. May them new people for you in the name of Jesus. Arise unto them today. In Jesus' mighty name. For those that are in prison, Father Lord, Rabbi Hebesanda, that did nothing wrong, oh Lord God Almighty, arise unto them. Let their cases be reviewed, that they will be sent home in the name of Jesus. Those who have, Father Lord, problem with drugs, Father Lord, let them be sent to treatment facilities in the name of Jesus. Father, we bless you for what you alone can do in our midst, Lord God. For you, our God, we bless you. Oh, Rabbi Heber, Santa Rabbi, we lift up various situations in our homes to you today. Father, we pray for peace in our families. We pray that husbands and wives will be united in one purpose in Christ. We come against everything that will cause division. We come against every rumor, every lie coming from the pit of hell to cause confusion in families. We pray, oh Lord God, against the spirit of suspicion in the name of Jesus. We pray for that Lord. We renounce every deception in the name of Jesus. Every secret, we renounce in the name of Jesus. We renounce every shame in the mighty name of Jesus. We uphold the truth in our families in the name of Jesus. We pray that your spirit continue to lead us, Jehovah God. We pray that we be true love, Lord, Lord, in our families in the name of Jesus. We pray for peace, O Lord God, in Jesus' mighty name. We pray, Jehovah God, that husbands and wives, Father Lord, we work for you in Jesus' mighty name. Oh, Jehovah God, we come against every spirit of strife in the name of Jesus. Oh, Father, we silence everything from the pit of hell today. We come against every evil arrow shot against families back to senders in the name of Jesus. We return every evil cancer upon the heads of senders. We break every monitoring gadget that the enemy is using to monitor our families. Anyone that has taken items belonging to us, pictures belonging to husband and wife and children, Father Lord, they have put them on separate altars and they are pressing pins on those pictures and causing confusion and trying to evoke spirit against husband and wives and their families in the name of Jesus. Arise unto us, disgrace, O Lord God, those people that are doing evil today. Let them be trampled upon by your mighty power. Let them be disgraced and brought them to repentance in Jesus' mighty name. Arise unto us, O Lord God, and help us. Restore back to us and our families the things that belong to us. Restore back, Father Lord, the joy of our salvation. In the name of Jesus, we bless you, our Father. You are our God. You hear us when we cry out to you. We have not come to you, Father Lord, because you cannot help us. We have come to you because you have helped us so many times. You will help us again in the work of Shedda. As we are calling out to you today in the name of Jesus. Oh, Father, we pray, Father Lord, for peace in our Father's household in the mighty name of Jesus. From the families of which we are born into in the name of Jesus. We lift up our siblings to you today. Wherever they are, we pray that you touch them. We pray, Father Lord, that siblings will be united in true love. We come against every confusion, everything erected in our families that have caused core problems in the name of Jesus. Oh, Father, we thank you for restoration of relationship and friendship in their families in the name of Jesus. We thank you for the peace of God upon our families. We thank you for rebuking the enemy on our behalf. We thank you for wisdom speaking to us today that we must reunite our families, O Lord God. That is where there is unity that you bestow the blessings in the name of Jesus. We come against every spirit of division. We come against every mindless. We come against every unforgiving spirit. Arise unto us in the name of Jesus. Have your way in our lives. We come against every lie and every secrecy in the name of Jesus. Any member of the extended family, Father Lord, causing confusion, Father Lord, in household, we come against them by the blood of Jesus Christ. Oh, let them surrender to you this day in the name of Jesus. Oh, let them lift up their hands, O Lord God, and repent of their sins, O Lord God, in the mighty name of Jesus. Father, we bless you for what you look into in the name of Jesus. We thank you, God, as you touch us that are mourning the death of loved ones today, as you reassure them that you are God in their situations. Oh, God Almighty, give them the comfort they need today. In the name of Jesus, thank you that the loved ones are resting in your person. In the name of Jesus, that those of us are life, Father Lord, we order our days, O Lord God, with wisdom. In the name of Jesus, that we think about where we spend eternal life in Jesus' mighty name. Glory, hallelujah, amen. Jehovah God, we are lifting up to you today. Your children that do not have jobs, that do not have food, that are thinking, where will their help come from? Jehovah God, send help today. Touch them this day. Oh God, help them. Let your light shine in their situations in the mighty name of Jesus. We pray that we meet you at the elevation of beauty this morning. We bless you for what you have done in our families, Father Lord. We thank you for touching our parents and our grandparents, Father Lord. We bless you, Father Lord, for restoring perfect health to them in old age. We thank you that you gladden their hearts, Lord God. We thank you, Jehovah God, Father Lord, that their testimonies are overflowing of your goodness. In the name of Jesus, we thank you that you are they're still strong for you in all age, in Jesus' mighty name. Oh, Father, thank you. Continue to use them to do great works in the mighty name of Jesus and compass around them with your holy presence. We pray that the children, Father, will remember their parents in old age. We pray that the church and the communities will be there to take care of their needs in the name of Jesus. Father, we bless you for what you alone will do. Oh, we thank you, Father, Lord. In the name of Jesus, for you are our God. Oh, Father, you have not rejected us. We thank you for the body of Christ, Lord God. We bless you for your children that have gone forth into the mission feet, O Lord God. We thank you that your word, O Lord God, is a lamp unto their feet and a light unto their path in the mighty name of Jesus. We thank you that you are leading them, Father Lord, into the nations, O Lord God. We have people are waiting, Father Lord, for the salvation, for the gospel, Father Lord. We thank you, Father Lord, that souls are coming into your kingdom. We thank you that you are giving us a great commission, that you already sent us forth into the nations in the name of Jesus. We thank you that we are obedient to your way in Jesus' mighty name. We bless you for the huge harvest of souls around the world. We thank you for signs, wonders, and miracles this done in the nations through you in the name of Jesus Christ. We bless you, Father Lord, for overturning captivity. We bless you, God, for blessing those that are in chains today. You say, blessed are those that are persecuted for righteousness' sake, that they will inherit your kingdom. Yes, they will inherit your kingdom in the name of Jesus. Thank you, Father Lord, for breaking chains, O Lord God. Thank you for opening prisons and allowing your children to come out in the name of Jesus. Thank you for leading them to the marketplaces to testify about the gospel of salvation to the nations, O Lord God. Thank you for the great works you do through them. Thank you that they are baptizing people in your name, in the name of your Son, and in the name of the Holy Spirit. Thank you that they're casting out demons in the mighty name of Jesus. Thank you that they're laying their hands on the sick and they're receiving healing. Thank you, Jehovah God, that they're teaching the truth, oh Lord God. Oh, Rabbi Heaven Sandama. He never motioned that ever have to the nations in the name of Jesus. Thank you that they are encouraging your children because the Spirit of God is upon us. Oh, Father, we bless you. In the name of Jesus. For your Spirit is upon the church, Lord God. In the mighty name of Jesus. That when we come together, we are gathered in your name. We come against the activity of false prophets and teachers in our midst, Lord God. We frustrate their cancer today. We press back against them. They cannot prevail against us in the mighty name of Jesus. We come against those, Father Lord, that have separate altars, Lord God. They put their hands, Lord God, in the house of God. And their hands are in the occult. We come against their evil, Father Lord. Oh, Rabbi, they will not defy our gathering in the mighty name of Jesus. They will not cause confusion and miss in the name of Jesus. They will not stand against us in the name of Jesus. We press back against them. We prevail against them today in the name of Jesus. Father, we bless you, God. In Jesus' mighty name, we come in your name, Jehovah God. We are gathered in your name, the Father, in the name of Jesus. We are blessed in your name, in Jesus' mighty name. We thank you for divine order within the body of Christ. We bless you for the ministry of your Holy Spirit. We thank you for the works your Spirit will do in us today. We do not have to pray or what we ought to pray. Your Spirit will pray for us today. In grace, which you understand, Jehovah God. You will search our hearts and you know what your Spirit is saying on our behalf today. So that the living God, arise unto the body of Christ today. We pray for unity within the body of Christ. We pray that the house of God will be the house of prayer. We pray that we will be positioned and right within the body of Christ. That each of us begin to use our spiritual gifts to bless the kingdom. We come against everything that will stand in our way today. In the name of Jesus, we flood the blood, our local assemblies and churches today with the blood of Jesus Christ. As a children, we come from far and near today, gathered in your name, Father Lord. As we go into the new year, Jehovah God, oh Rabbi Heaven, Center of Ahobashan, we pray for your divine presence in our midst today. We pray that our gathering will be unto you today. We pray for miracles in our midst today. We pray for breaking of chains today. In the mighty name of Jesus, we pray that you announce the mouth of everyone, Father Lord, that we stand on your altar to talk to us today. In the name of Jesus, that they will speak as your oracles. In the mighty name of Jesus, we come against deception. We come against every lying tongue. We come against every word from the pit of hell today. We overturn every prophecy that will not of you today. In the name of Jesus, in Jesus Christ, the spirit of prophecy has made complete, Jehovah God. We know you have given us peace on earth. Any prophecy that will not bring peace and encouragement to your children today, we tear them down by your mighty power. In the name of Jesus, release unto us today all the prophecy of goodwill, of peace, of revelation, of prosperity in the name of Jesus, all our power in the name of Jesus, of ability to do great works for you, all of joy and rejoicing, Jehovah God. In the name of Jesus, release unto our prophecy from every king, with this battle of God, with every wisdom in the name of Jesus. Oh God Almighty, speak to your children today. In the name of Jesus, arise unto us today. Do great works in our midst today. Overturn every cancer of the wicked today. Give your children renewed hope today. In the name of Jesus, give us strength to run. In the name of Jesus, to go into the new year, oh Lord God. Determine to do great works for you. In the name of Jesus, overturn everything out of you today. Let your light shine in our midst today. In the name of Jesus, anoint our tongue to speak as your oracle. For you, oh God, encompass around our nations today. Encompass around our families today. Pull down every struggle today, every gathering of the enemy, all those that are planning attack against our nations, against the three cities of God that are planning against America, against the plan of Boko Haram against Nigeria, the plan against West Africa, the plan against Africa, against all the nations of the world, Jehovah God, against Europe, oh Lord God, against France, oh Lord God, arise unto us, the plan against America, against South and North America, in the name of Jesus, oh Rabbi Kabashinda, against all the Lord of Asia, in the name of Jesus, against all the Lord of Heaven Center, Australia, whatever they are planning, Jehovah God, overturned by your mighty power, in the name of Jesus, oh Father, arise unto us today. Lead your children with faith and with your peace today, with your joy today, in the name of Jesus. Do what you can do today as we travel by ever, land by sea, Jehovah God. Protect us from evil in the name of Jesus. Encompass around our nations today, oh God Almighty, as our children gather today in Times Square, Jehovah God, to bring in new year, Father God, in the various nations of the world, as they gather together and congregate today. Let them gather in your name, in the name of Jesus. Protect them, Jehovah God, in the mighty name of Jesus. Give our law enforcement strength, Lord God. Give them, Father Lord, enlightenment, O Lord God, of their eyes to see clearly. In the name of Jesus, frustrate, O Lord God, anyone trying to come against your children today. Oh, Father, your children are celebrating this day. Remain center of a home of shelter for what you have done for us in the name of Jesus. Help us, O Lord God. We are crying out to you. Do not allow evil prevail in heaven, center. In the name of Jesus. Oh, Father, Rabbi
heathen son of Homo Shender, send the foundation of evil today, bend the nation safe for your children today, wherever they congregate today, in your name, Jehovah God, they are gathering in the mighty name of Jesus, protect them, Jehovah God, remember, send them above God, keep us safe today, in the name of Jesus, we thank you, God, send the foundation of the earth for us today, in the mighty name of Jesus, release benefits upon your children today, let your children seek your face, Father Lord, in the name of Jesus, let the prayer of the spirit of prayer descend upon your children, Father, the spirit of discernment today, in the name of Jesus, oh Father, renew our strength today, oh Father, we bless you for what you are doing for us today, oh Father, we bless you for you have released grace upon us today, we thank you, our Father, in Jesus' mighty and precious name, oh Father, we bless you, God, in the name of Jesus, thank you, God, for our spiritual fathers and mothers, we lift them to you today, we commit their families into your hands today, we present their husbands and wives to you today, in the name of Jesus, and compass them with your holy presence, Jehovah God, lift up their heads, oh Lord God, against every stale defiler, in the name of Jesus, use them to do great works to you, for us today, in the name of Jesus, Father, anoint their mouths to speak as your oracles today, Father, prepare them for the services of this night, oh Lord God, prune and purge and remove from them everything contrary to your will, let them see today, let them see to the spiritual realm today, oh Father, release to them, oh Rabba Shenda, oh the spirit of prophecy, in the name of Jesus, release to them today, what is it to speak to your children, to encourage your children, to enlighten your children, to give them power to them, in the name of Jesus, to bring shifts today, to release healing, in the name of Jesus, Father, we bless you, God, in the name of Jesus, we thank you, God, for feeding us today, with spiritual food, in the name of Jesus, for leading us as we go out and come in, you are our God, we bless you for what you have done, glory, hallelujah, amen. Father, we thank you, for because we know you are shaking the kingdom of darkness on our behalf today. Father, Lord, you have restored to us everything that belongs to us. You have given us our life back. In the name of Jesus, you have touched our children today. Our children are prospering. In the name of Jesus, they are blessed by the names you have called them. No one can lift up a standard against the names of our children. They are blessed by their names in the name of Jesus. We bless you, God, in Jesus' mighty and precious name. Glory, hallelujah, amen. Father, thank you for answered prayers. Thank you for what you have done for us today. Receive the praise, receive the honor in Jesus' mighty and precious name. As we go into the study of your word today, enlighten our eyes and help us in the name of Jesus. That every word that we feed on, we produce the fruit of righteousness in us in Jesus' name. Glory, hallelujah, hallelujah, amen. Praise the Lord, hallelujah, amen. The Lord reigns, blessed be our God, be the rock of our salvation, be exalted, may God be exalted in our lives today in Jesus' mighty name, amen. This morning, I want to read from the book of 1 John chapter 3. I want to read a few verses. Glory, hallelujah, amen. I want to remind us of the love that our Father has lavished on us, amen. And we are called the children of God. Glory, hallelujah, amen. How great is the love the Father has lavished on us, that we should be called children of God. Again, how great is the love the Father has lavished on us, that we should be called children of God. And that is what we are. We are children of God. Amen. God has lavished such a love on us that we cannot even understand why God loves us the way he does. Amen. Such a great love. Amen. On us. How great is the love the Father has lavished on us, that we should be called children of God, and that is what we are. The reason the world does not know us is that it did not know him. Dear friends, now we are children of God, and what we will be has not yet been made known. But we know that when he appears, we shall be like him, for we shall see him as he is. Glory, hallelujah, amen. Everyone who has this hope in him purifies himself just as he is pure. If you know that you are the child of God, if you know that God has lavished such a great love on you, that God sent Jesus Christ to die for us because of that love that God has for us, God said nothing can separate us from his love. Live as a child of God, for our God is holy, our God is pure. That everyone that has the hope that one day that we'll see our Lord and Savior, we will meet our God when our Lord appears, has that hope in them. And because we have that hope in us, we should purify ourselves of all unrighteousness, because just the way our Lord is pure, that's the way we are pure. God created us to be a pure people, a holy people unto him. So let us continue to purify ourselves and prepare ourselves for the coming of our Lord. That all of creation is waiting with groans. We are crying within us, our spirit crying within us for a revelation of God's children. But one good thing is that we already know within us, because the Spirit agrees with our spirit that we are the children of God. Amen. God has lavished great love on us. So we do not doubt that we are the children of God. As all of creation is waiting for the revelation of God's children, we already know that we are God's children. Creation does not know, because creation did not accept our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ as Lord and Savior. Creation does not know God because they rejected His Son. The world here has been blinded. The God of this world has blinded those that are still in the world. Amen? The world is walking on a path different from that path that God wants us to walk on. So as children of God, we must purify ourselves and draw every day near to God. Feed on the living word of God so that we know what God has given to us. We know ourselves because God has lavished such great a love on us. Amen. He has called us His children. As many that believe in Jesus Christ, He gave power to become the children of God. We are the children of God. We are empowered to do great works for Him because we know that we are the children of God. We have the love of God in us. That love of God should make us purify ourselves. We read yesterday that no one should say that they are tempted by God when they are tempted. Amen. That God does not tempt anyone. That we are tempted when we are drawn away from God. When we are allowed the lust, when we are tainted by our own evil desires. When we are drawn away from the presence of God. Then that desire we have in us produces, we become pregnant within us. And it produces sin. And sin produces death. Amen. So let us know that God tempts no man. God does not tempt any man, but we tempt ourselves. God has called us to a righteous life, to a holy life unto Him. Let us draw nearer to the God that loves us. Let us serve Him and serve humanity. Draw away from the crooked path on which we are walking on and come back to God. Because we know we are the children of God and that God has lavished such a great love on us. The life we are living is the life of Jesus Christ. Someone died for us to have the life we have today. Let us live that life to give God pleasure through the things we do in the name of Jesus. So today we know that God has such a great love for us. And we are the children of God. Because we are the children of God and we have a great hope that one day that God will be revealed to us. We see God just the way He is. We purify ourselves of every unrighteousness. Through the power of God working in us, because we know on our own we cannot do that in the name of Jesus, because we are in flesh and blood. But the Spirit of God helps us in Jesus' name. Glory, hallelujah, amen. This morning I said we are going to continue with our study of the book of Matthew. We just read a few verses from the Matthew chapter 4 in the name of Jesus, amen. The temptation of Jesus Christ. Then Jesus was led by the Spirit into the desert to be tempted by the devil. After fasting 40 days and 40 nights, He was hungry. The tempter came to Him and said, "If you are the Son of God, tell these stones to become bread." Jesus answered, "It is written, man does not live on bread alone, but on every word that comes from the mouth of God." Glory, hallelujah, amen. We stop here. We thank God that even our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ passed through everything that we will ever pass through in flesh and blood. He passed through temptation. He was baptized. He was revealed to us. Amen. And the people who were there heard a voice saying that this is the beloved Son of God, in whom God is well pleased. It's still well pleased of Him. In the name of Jesus, I use the past tense. In the name of Jesus. After that, He was led by the Spirit of the living God into the wilderness. He fasted 40 days and 40 nights. And at the point when He was very hungry, Satan, the devil, appeared to tempt Him, to entice Him with food. He knew that Jesus Christ was hungry, and He told Him. The tempter came in to Him and said, "If you are the Son of God, tell these stones to become bread." But thank God for the living word of God that is in Jesus Christ. The living word of God in us to be brought out. The arrow, that word we should use as a weapon against the enemy. When the enemy comes against us, the enemy will not come at the time that we are full, at the time that we have everything. The enemy will come at the time that we are lonely, at the time that we are hungry, at the time that we lack things, at the time that people have left us, that we find ourselves as if we are alone in this world, as if there's no one to love us, at the time that we are passing through challenges, at the time that we have no money, at the time that we are thinking about buying things to our families, we do not have it. The enemy will come at that time. At the time that there's a problem between husband and wives. And that's why we must pray always that there should be unity in the families. that the husband and wife will be close, that each of them will perform their duties to one another, so that there will be no temptation, nothing coming from outside to tempt people at a time of lack, at a time of deprivation. Amen. So the tempter came at that time. The tempter knew that Jesus Christ was hungry. Amen. That when someone is hungry, the person needs food. Someone that had fasted 40 days and 40 nights, and he appeared at that time. Took the opportunity and appeared, and that's the way the enemy comes. So that's why we must be spiritually alert at every time, every moment of our lives. Draw close to God. Remember who we are. Remember that we do not wrestle against flesh and blood. Remember that in this world that we are in, that this world, that the evil force of darkness is here trying to hinder every good work that God wants to do through us. For the force of darkness in this world knows that God has given us power. That through Jesus Christ we can do great things from God. That nothing is impossible for us to do. That we can pray for the sick, that we receive healing. That we can put our hands on the sick and they will stand up from the sick bed in the name of Jesus. We can restore health to people. We can encourage people. We can baptize people in the name of the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit. We can cast out demons. We can do great works for God. We can teach this the word of truth. When we remain in our rightful position without compromising with the word, we can be pure and holy unto our God. The enemy knows that. So the enemy is trying to come against every good seed God has sown in us, trying to uproot those good seed and putting evil and fear into us in the name of Jesus. So we must be alert spiritually all the time, wherever we are. We must know that the enemy is always there, trying to see what we are doing, trying to observe, trying to see where we are going to, trying to see how we can overcome. But we are overcomers in the name of Jesus Christ. God who has given us everything will help us to overcome in the name of Jesus Christ. So let us know, we do not receive the food given to us by the enemy at a time that we should abstain from eating in the name of Jesus. We do not accept the gifts given to us from the pit of hell, because it will come with great recompense, with great consequences in the name of Jesus. When God has given us inner strength, we stand on the foundation God has given to us. We pursue righteousness in the name of Jesus Christ. We bring down that word of God that has been sown into us to begin to rebuke Satan. You say, rebuke the enemy and he will depart from you. He will resist the enemy with everything within us. The enemy will depart from us in the name of Jesus. The enemy will appear again, because the enemy will not give up. But we, the children of God, will not give up. God has given us the power to prevail. We prevail against the forces of darkness. We are standing on the word of God, the living word of God that has given us power in the name of Jesus. And Jesus Christ knew what he had in him. He knew that he would not accept anything from Satan. He spoke the word of God to rebuke the enemy, to come against that evil in the name of Jesus. He said, and Jesus Christ said that it is written, man does not live on bread alone, but on every word that comes out from the mouth of God. We pray today that we will live on every word that comes out from the mouth of God, that will not seek bread, that will seek the kingdom of God, because that word of God will feed us in the name of Jesus. We take care of every need that we have in the name of Jesus. God is faithful. He will do what he alone will do in our lives in Jesus' mighty name. Oh, we come against every tempter today. We come against every tempter. For the word of God said, woe to him through whom temptation comes. We are going out in the name of God. In the name of God, we do the things we do today. In the name of Jesus, and we go into 2016. We are going in the name of God. We rebuke the tempter in the name of Jesus. We are feeding on the word of God. We are standing on the foundation God has laid for us. We are doing the work that God has called us to do. The power of God will prevail in our lives. The counsel of God will prevail in the name of Jesus. We uproot every temptation within our families, within our families, wherever the tempter is hiding. Father, expose them in the name of Jesus. For you are God. You do not tempt anyone. Let no one say that they are tempted by God. When temptation comes, God tempts no one. We are tempted when we are drawn away from the presence of God. Father, let us remain in our rightful positions, in our families, in our communities. Oh God, in Him is center, in our government, in the name of Jesus, within the body of Christ, in the name of Jesus, wherever you have placed us, let us lift up the banner of Jesus Christ. We come against the tempter today, in the name of Jesus, triumphantly, Jehovah God. We go into 2016. We work for you, Jehovah God. Man shall not live by bread alone, but by every word that proceeds out of your mouth. Speak to us today. Feed us today. In the name of Jesus. Let every word you release on us today produce the fruit of righteousness in us today. In the name of Jesus. Have your way in our lives, our God. We bless you, God. We thank you, God, that you're opening our eyes. You're enlightening our eyes. You're renewing our minds. You're pruning and purging and removing from us everything contrary to your will. We give you a clap of praise for being our Father. We bless you, God, in Jesus' mighty name. You are God. God. Receive all the praise and honor for what you have done for us today. In Jesus' mighty and precious name, we have prayed. Glory. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Amen. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Amen. The Lord reigns. Blessed be our God. May the rock of our salvation be exalted. May God be exalted in our lives today. In Jesus' mighty and precious name, we have prayed. Glory. Hallelujah. Amen. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Amen. God loves you. We love you too.